Hello, and in this video we're going to be using Onshape to make a custom template title block to use for drawing pages. So to do this first, I'm just going to start a new document. I'm just going to call it sample template, and we'll start a template. To go from there, I want to upload an image so I can use that image on my template. So I'm just going to do a sketch, and I'm going to upload an image using that sketch so I have an image to work with. Nothing too crazy, nothing too complicated here. We just want to enter an image, and then I'm just going to import just a picture from my computer. I'm just going to use this high school's here, and we'll just use our logo. It's going to upload, and then I can select that to put onto my background here. So I can make it, and there we go, we got it. I'm just going to hit the green check, and I'm just going to leave that there, and next I'm going to start a new drawing page. So I'll come down to the plus sign here on the bottom, and I hit create drawing. I'm just going to use one of the defaults. I've been using the int one recently, so I'm going to use that one. If you want to use a different one, you can go to Onshape and pick from the different options, but I'm just going to use the anti-int one. I'm going to hit OK to open it, and it's going to give me that template. Once it opens, I have my template. It's got my title block. I don't want to use this title block. I want to make changes to it. And again, I'm using an A size piece of paper, which is going to be your typical printed paper. And if you need a different size, you have to customize for your each individual size. But first, what I want to do is just select all of these options down here on the bottom and get rid of all of them. You can highlight them all and delete. Or if you can't do that, you can delete them each one individually. I got most of them here. I'm going to pause it and get the rest of them, and then we'll come back and see so now that we've cleared out our page, we're going to now create our title block. I'm just going to rough outline and keep this video going pretty quickly. So I'm not going to measure anything out on this particular video. But I'm just going to start on the far side and go straight across horizontally to the opposite side. And that's just starting my title block. I'm going to hit escape to exit the line tool, and then hit insert, and I'm going to insert that image I just uploaded. So I'm just going to make the image, and then I'll drag it down, and luckily I made it the right size. Otherwise you can resize it once you have it in the right location. So now I got my symbol down there, so I'm going to block that out using a line. So I have my location, and I'm just going to block it out with the line tool. So now I have that edge of my title block created. Next, I'm going to create some horizontal lines to separate this into three rows. So I'm just going to, again, I'm just roughly going, you can measure, use your tools and make those perfect. But I'm just trying to do it really quickly and give you a rough estimate of what it looks like. So I go straight across, and I'm going to make that one a little bit higher. And we get our three lines down here. Next, I'm going to put my actual wording in for my title block. So in this case, I come up and I grab what says note. You want to make sure when you're clicking note, if you just want to type, you don't want to have that orange box show up. That's going to give you a leader line. So we just want it to say note. And now I'm going to drag it all the way across in this case so it centers my text. And then I can just start typing. So in this case, I'm just going to put the name of the high school, Wright City High School. And then our course is PLTW Intro to Engineering. In this case, I want to center it, so I'm going to center my text and make sure it's right in the middle, and then I'm going to hit the green check to accept. You can change the text, you can change the size here if you want, but we're just trying to make an outline of what we want. Then I'm going to put another note, so I'm going to come down in my next note, and I'm going to call this one my part. I want my part name, so I'm going to come to these bottom tabs here, and we can insert different properties. So I can insert the name of that part here. So I can hit insert name. I didn't put any colons, so I'm going to insert some colons in, and then hit my space. And now it's going to default my part name. Once I upload my part, it's going to put that part in. So I hit my green check and accept. Then below that, I'm going to hit another note. I'm going to try to line up. I'm going to pull this line back, and I'm only going to go to this center line I already have here. Next, I'm going to put the drawing, the date of the drawing. So I'm just going to label date and hit a space. And then I'm going to come over. And now I'm on the second one over where I'm looking at my drawing properties to insert. And I just want drawing date drawn. And I'm going to put that in. And it's popping up today's day or whatever date you start your drawing on is what's going to pop up there. I hit my green check to accept. Then I'm going to insert some lines. I'm just going to separate. I'm just going to go straight up from this line that's already on here. That way I have plenty of room for my part and my date. Once I have that, then I'm going to add some more notes. So my next note's going to come down. And again, I want to make sure I'm in. And this time I'm going to go to just about the one. Next, I want the date, the name or what drawn by. So I want to know who draws it. So again, I'm going to insert drawing property and it's going to have drawing drawn by. And it's going to do that. And then it defaults whoever is creating the drawing, their name in that location. So I hit my green check. Then below that, I'm going to come down and make yet another note. Again, same length, same location, and I can insert another property. So in this case, really what properties you insert up to you. I could do it in scripts and I could do part numbers, things like that of the part, or I could actually do different things for the drawing. In this case, I want my drawing title. So in this case, I have last change. I could do last change, but I want my drawing name. That way, if I have a different name for my part name, I have that drawing name. And I forgot to insert my label ahead of it, so I'm going to insert my label first. Drawing name. And then I insert and hit drawing name. And right now its default is drawing one. If I change the name, I can update it. I can come up here and hit the update button for the update. And then I'll do my green check. Again, I'm going to insert a line to separate my categories. So I'm going to go just to the right of this one here. That way, if I have a long drawing name, it fits. And then I'm going to add my last notes in. So I'm going to, again, choose my notes, hit note. Then I'm going to label it with a scale so I know what scale my drawing's in. And again, insert drawing property. And we want drawing scale, sheet scale. So I insert that and green check. If you're going to have more than one page, it's useful to know what page we're on. So that's what's going to go down here on the bottom. So I click, I'm going to type in sheet. And a colon and space. And I'm going to insert a sheet number. And then after that, I'm going to hit back in the text. And I'm going to hit space, slash, and then another space. And I want to know how many sheets I have total. That way I know where I'm at. So I'm going to put total sheets after that. And then hit my green check. So that kind of sets up our template. Now we have to save that template. Or in this case, it's going to be an export of that template. Once we export the template, then you can download it and save it, and it's going to be a template for you to work with. So if we want to export it, you just right-click on the drawing. So in this case, drawing one, export. And we want to make sure it's a DWT file. That means it's a template file. So you give it your name. So I'm going to say Wildcat template because it's got the Wildcat on it. And then we can export it. When we export it, it downloads to your computers. Typically, it ends up in your downloads. You can see it pops up here. Then, once you've downloaded it, once you've exported it, and it's on in your download folder or wherever you have it set to export in your computer, then you can come back to your Onshape, and then you go create and import files. Once you import that file, so I'm just going to go to my downloads. Once I import that Wildcat template, open. Then it's going to be a template available whenever I open a part. So I have some different parts already open, and I'm just going to pull down this practice part I have open here. And then once I hit the plus sign, I can hit create drawing. And then created by me, I have those templates available. So I have my Wildcat template, and I can hit OK, and that template's available for me to now use. So hopefully this helps you to create a template. Once you have it, you can insert your image and insert whatever you need into that drawing page, and it should automatically update with the info from your document. So hopefully that helps. If you have any questions, make sure you get them squared away. Good luck.